put this on Instagram real quick. Share. Copy link. Instagram. Linky link. Copy, paste. Link. Done. Hello, Deb. I just realized I have something in my denture. Hold on, let me cut it. I hope you can't see this. I don't think I got it, but hello. Hello. Oh, thank you, Cray Cray. Yeah, please like this live stream. It helps a lot. Okay, let me pull up your comments on my phone. I'm very frustrated because I freaking put on my story all of the, like, for, like, a Q&A that I wanted to do, right? And I didn't save, I didn't screenshot any of them because I thought that on Instagram, you know how you can go into your archive and you can find your stories, your past stories? So I found the story, but it wouldn't give me the results. It wouldn't give me the questions that people sent in. So all of those amazing questions, I wish I could remember what they were. They're gone now. And I got a few questions in the comments of my latest video, but I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll just go live instead and answer questions live and get back into the swing of things and do all the things of the times and the places. So here we are. And hello, and does anyone have any questions? I know I should be able to, Darcy, but that's why I'm so frustrated. It always works. I've done it before. I swear I've done it before. I swear, but it's not working. It's really annoying. Let me show you. You'll just believe me, it's not working. So anyway, so let's see, what can I tell you until I get some questions? Today I had therapy. I vlogged a little bit today, so you might be getting a vlog soon. I talked about what we talked in therapy. Danny left yesterday? Yeah. He'll be gone for 3 weeks, and I know, I'm so annoyed, Darcy, you have no idea. He'll be gone for 3 weeks, and he is in, should know this, Illinois, I think. So that's cool. Been going through some rough family stuff. I have a very close family member who's diagnosed with cancer. And I have another very close family member who's in the ICU right now with a brain bleed and stroke and having to get their heart jumped and all the whatever that's called. So if any of you pray out there or send good vibes, whatever you do, there are a couple people in my family that are not well at the moment. So anyway, what have you learned in therapy? Oh, I lost your comment. What have you learned in therapy? And do you think it would be good for others to know? Yes. So I'm glad you asked because I want to start doing therapy Thursdays, but not like commit like every week, just do it when I can do it. Cause I'm not going to commit anymore to things because that just ends up letting people down. And then I feel guilty and then I take it out on myself and all the things. So, but I want to like do like therapy Thursdays or something. So you'll see that on Thursday. You'll see my vlog of what helped me the most in therapy this week. And I can share just like my experiences and maybe they'll help you. Yeah. So yes, I have. Sorry if I'm like weird today. I'm kind of in a dissociative place today, but not like super bad, just like a little bit fuzzy. You know what I mean? Just a little bit like, thank you. Thank you for the prayers, good thoughts, whatever you do. You don't have to pray if you don't pray. Just whatever you do, just keep my those two found. I'm not going to say who it is because I don't have their permission. It's their medical history. It's their thing going on. It's not mine. So, but they are two very, very, very close to me family members that you guys know. So just keep them in your prayers, please. That would be great. Okay. Let's see. J-Dot, my birthday is coming in 15 days. I'll be 35 years old this year. Happy birthday in 15 days. I'm going to be 38 soon. Ugh. I'm so old. Penny. Maggie, hi. Let's see. What do you want to know about? What do you want to see? I have exciting news for you. I'm bringing back the seasonal tree. And the next one that you'll see is the Halloween tree. Normally I would just do sunflowers in September, but I decided to decorate early for that for Halloween because I love it. Working on decorating my Halloween tree. It's gonna be really cute. And it's downstairs. I hope we're not having issues. Is it paused? You guys want me to sing? Thank you. Wait, oh, is it pausing? I don't think it's your own, Debbie. Oh, dang it. Okay, how about now? Is it better now? These are the things that made my toddler cry today. Oh, these are the things that made him so uncontrollably. If you know what that is, we can be best friends. Okay, I think we're good again. Okay, good. Sorry about that. Has therapy and meds helping to hold things stable? We're working on it. Therapy has been really good, really hard, but good. Making some major, major progress in therapy. I'm very proud of it, honestly. Meds are still being figured out for, some of my stuff. I had to go off of the stuff that helped with my schizoaffective disorder, and so my schizoaffective has been acting up a little bit. But that medicine just was awful for me personally, but everyone's different. So we're working on it. Oh, thank you, Sloth Bear. OMG, your voice is beautiful and so sweet. That's so nice of you. I'm really hard on myself. I come from a musical family. Both my parents were musical, and both of them have like a musical ear. So I got like double the musical ear. So I can hear things perfectly. I can hear pitches and tones and all that stuff. I can hear it perfectly, but I can't execute it well. And so I always get frustrated with myself because while I'm singing, I'm like, that was flat, that was sharp, that was off, that was bad, that was awful, blah, blah, blah. So that's why I don't know. But I do want to start singing some more for you guys if you'd like. I think I fixed the connection, right? I hope. Good job, Brittany. We can be best friends. Let's see. Love you dearly, but let's refrain from talking about a number weight loss here. Thank you. Just for future references, that can be very triggering. Thanks, Tasha. Stasia, I still don't know. This happens literally every time. Stasia, 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 Stasia. Literally every time this happens. I'll never get it, I swear. How come some of yours are like a black background and some of you are a white background, your comments? What's that about? What's happening? Is it just the lighting? What is this right here? It's just the lighting. Are you feeling more comfortable in the new house? That's from Kimberly Douglas. Well, I was. I still feel comfortable and safe in my room. That's kind of been my safe space since we got here. Like, I made it my safe space. And I have not made yet the rest of the house safe yet for me. So I spend my time mostly up here. Unless Danny's with me, then we'll hang out downstairs. But like, if I'm alone, I don't know. It's hard for me to be down there. I don't know. I've been feeling, I don't want to complain about this because I'm so blessed to have such a beautiful home and a home that a lot of people don't have and that would love, and a home that I always dreamed about growing up that I would someday live in. It's a beautiful home, so I always feel really bad, like, but the truth is that I've been feeling really homesick. that homesick feeling that I was feeling when we very first moved in, that's starting to come back, but it could also be because Danny left, and I knew he was gonna leave this past week, and so it got me, like, even more anxious and unsafe feeling, but I'm sure I'll get there. Like, I know that I'll be okay and I'll get there. I just, not everywhere in my house feels safe and comfortable for me, but that's why I stay in the places that I need to be, depending on my mood and what's going on. What is in my eye? What is happening? I can't get it out. Anyway. Hello, Closey. I always forget your real name. What's your real name? Yeah, Danny is my home. That's understandable. Exactly, Kay. Move this up here. That's better. Okay. Megan said, I forget. What does Danny do? So Danny works in the film industry. He mostly does prop work. Like, he'll build props for commercials and movies and all kinds of famous things. He's such a famous whore. Just kidding. I love him. I'm so proud of him. And so they travel around sometimes to different locations to film. He usually does like prop master stuff and he builds props. He's so freaking talented. But sometimes he'll help with other jobs on set, like key grip or, well, maybe not key grip. I don't know what that means. I just know it's a thing, but I don't know if he actually, I forget whatever else he's told me that he does. But mostly he does like props and set design and set building and things like that. And he's so talented at it. He's amazing. It was Chloe. I changed it to River though. When I came out as non-binary, no worries about remembering. Okay. River, 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 Closey River. Okay, well, your profile picture looks like a vagina to me. Is it a vagina? A very strong vagina? Okay, so river. Vaginas are the rivers of the sex times. I don't know where I'm going. I don't. Yes, River. Sage just changed their name as well. Was who diagnosed? Was I diagnosed with diabetes? What are we talking about? Oh, someone else was. Oh, J Dot, you were diagnosed. I'm so sorry. Oh, that must be really, really difficult. I'm so sorry. Hi, Paris. How are you? Nature names are so pretty. I agree. Hey, Batgirl. What's up? I missed you too, Paris. How are you? Don't be nervous, J-Dot. I mean, it's normal to be nervous, but you're going to be okay. Just follow what the doctors tell you to do. It's going to suck. It's really going to suck. But if you follow what they do, you can be here a very, very long time. My stepdad has diabetes. My birth dad has diabetes. And my grandpa had diabetes. Like, I've watched them go through it, and just do what the doctors tell you is very, very important. So, I look great. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Wow. Thanks. So do you, I'm sure. Oh no, Caitlin, I got let go from my job on Friday. Trying to find a new one is stressing me out. Oh no. I'm sorry, sweetie. I really, really, really hope that you can find a new job. That's so stressful. Was the new therapy you mentioned DBT? Just wondering as I've started DBT therapy lately. So right now I'm doing EMDR, which is another trauma therapy. DBT, we haven't done yet. Well, I've done it in the past with different therapists, but we've done some EMDR. So like, for instance, and it's really cool because I've never experienced it, and it's kind of fascinating to me how well it worked, because she wanted to do the first time we did it, she wanted me to pick a memory that was like obviously a traumatic memory that maybe wasn't like the most traumatic thing in the world, you know, it was kind of one of my lesser traumatic instances, and that's the one that we decided to focus on EMDR. And so I told her the memory, and I'll tell you guys as well. Some of you already know this, but I think I was like 8 or 9 years old, and I was really overweight as a kid, and I had a few bullies, but one in particular, we'll call him Joe. And Joe would always like tell me how fat I am and ugly and stupid and my teeth were crooked and all the things. He was a peach. And one day at the park, I was at the park with like 30 other kids, like from my school. It was just a bunch of kids around my age were around. And I remember being on this hill and being at the top of the hill, and I see Joe walk into the park, and I'm like, oh great, here we go. And there's like all kinds of kids around me and stuff like that. And he comes up to me and he gets everyone's attention, like at the top of the hill, like he gets everyone's attention, pulls out a porn magazine and opens it to the centerfold and starts comparing my body part by body part, how ugly my body part is compared to that, to the model. Like, he's like, okay, your boobs don't look good like hers do. Your stomach isn't flat like hers is. Your skin isn't tan like hers is. Your face is ugly and hers is beautiful. Like, just started picking apart my entire body and soul and comparing me to this pornography magazine, this centerfold lady. And I'm not kidding, not one kid stood up for me, not one kid stood up for me out of those 30 kids that were around. Granted, they were probably scared of him as well, and that's fine. But like, it just, sorry, is something going on in the comments? I don't know. It was hard and it was humiliating because they all laughed with him because I'm pretty sure they were, I think they were scared of him and felt like they had to laugh along with him as he was just pointing out my body parts and laughing at me. And then later in life, when I entered high school, I never, after elementary school was over, I didn't see Joe again. He went to a different junior high and high school, so I didn't see him again. And then one time we were in high school and there was this like huge party happening that everybody in the school's invited to, and me and my friends just like wanted to be cool and popular and wanted to fit in. So we're like, oh, we should totally go to this party because we were totally invited. Everyone was invited. So we go to the party. We get to the house and the house looks like there's no cars parked out. There's not a lot of lights on. You're not hearing music. It just didn't feel like it was a party. And we're like, what is going on? Maybe we have the wrong house. So we go and knock on the door and this dude answers the door. And we're like, hey, is this where the party is? And he's like, yeah, come on in. You guys are the first ones here. And we're like, oh, okay, that explains it. So he brings us in. Right after we come in, he slams the door and locks it behind us. And I got this feeling of like, shit, what is going on? Something does not feel right. And he's like, hey, why don't you guys come in and sit in the living room and chill with us? And so we came in and sat on the couch, and there were like three other guys there. And I just started to get a really bad feeling about them. So I was like, you know what, we actually need to go. And they're like, no, you're not leaving. And I'm like, well, I have to go. I'll come back later. I just have to go really quick. I have to go home to get something and then I'll come back or something. I don't know. And he's like, no, you have to stay. And he was literally like blocking the door. Like, we got up to leave and he blocked the door. And he's like, sit down. And at that point we were just terrified. So we did what he said. So we sat down and he brought out like, I don't know if it's a bong, I don't know what it's called, something that they lit where it went up in the air and gave us all a contact high. I don't know drugs, I don't know how it works. I just know that I started to feel it. And they started like asking us really inappropriate questions about ourselves and like sexual, like as if they were trying to groom us or something. And by the way, they were definitely in their 20s and we were, I don't know, 16 maybe at the time. And so it just was really creepy and I was like crying and so was my friend. We're like, how are we gonna get out of here? And then all of a sudden I see this guy walk in the room and it's Joe. It's the same Joe from elementary school that I hadn't seen since elementary school. And he walks in the room and he catches my eye and he looks at me like, freak, I know you. And I'm like, oh no, I know you too. And he just looked at me and then he paused for a second and he was like, guys, let them go. They're cool. And so they let us go. So funny turn of events that my childhood bully ended up saving my life later in life. I think that he looked at me and felt so bad about the way that he had treated me throughout elementary school that he was like, this is my way of saying I'm sorry or whatever. I don't know. But it was an absolute, like, yeah, he knew. He knew. It was amazing. Like, I'll never forget that. And I'll always appreciate that. I wish I could find him and tell him that, but it's okay. Anyway, but back to the park incident. That's the thing that we were working on in EMDR. And it's just so cool how she did it. She gave me these two little hand thing. I know, I didn't see it coming either. It gave me chills, and it gives me chills every single time I tell that story, just because I'm like, he could have used the pain that he had caused me and used that against me, and he knows that I'm a vulnerable person that always gets bullied and made fun of, and therefore I could be more taken advantage of easier. But just him looking just like shocked at my face and then just being like, guys, just let her go. Let them go. They're good. They're cool. I know them. It's okay. They can go. It was cool. Anyway, yes, my therapist has these two handheld things and they vibrate back and forth in your hand. So it goes bzz, 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 and that like activates both sides of your brain while you're talking. So it helps with memory and also helps with like processing trauma. And so I can say that I went into it, started, it took us two sessions, I believe. And I can tell, I can honestly tell you now that I completely feel at peace with that situation. Like, I've let it go, and it'll be there as a story to tell, you know, but other than that, it's not hurting me anymore. And it's something that I'm just learning. I'm just like shocked that it even worked. Like, I'm so, so shocked. No, I don't have a sore throat. I just sound like this all the time because I'm probably decades of bulimia did this to me, I'm guessing, but I sound like this a lot. Sorry. I know it's annoying. Anyway, yeah, so that's really, really cool to see that the process actually works. And I was like, what? This is insane. Because when we started, she's like, hey, scale of 1 to 10, how anxious do you get about this memory? Or how much does this memory affect you? And I think we started at like a 7. And then when we were all done, she's like, hey, so how much does this affect you negatively? And I said, it doesn't. I don't feel like it does. So anyway, I just think that's so cool. So anyway, so we're doing that with, you know, we're taking trauma by trauma. We're starting, you know, with a little bit of a lighter one, like that story. And then we're going to move up to, oh, good heavens, all the really hard ones. But it's really hard, but it's really good. And it actually works. I'm just shocked that it works. So anyway, it's hard, but we're good. We're working on it. Shani says, Shani, you're glowing. I hope you're doing better. I'm praying for you. You followed me the other day on Instagram. Oh yeah, are you the one with your daughter that did her hair? Wait, I need to show them this. Is that you? Can I show your daughter? Wait, I need to make sure this is the right person I'm thinking of. Did you hear that? That was my stomach. I ate Taco Bell like an hour ago and my stomach is like ready to visit the toilet for sure. Yeah, it will. Sloth Bear, I'm doing EMDR right now and it's been really rough, but I hope it will help. It will, if you stick to it. And if you do it. And for me, it was really hard the first session, and that's why it took 2 sessions to kind of dismiss that trauma. Because the first time I did it, I just, because she asks you, like, she'll stop the buzzers completely and ask you, what are you thinking when it comes to that memory? And then she'll turn the buzzers on again for like 20 seconds and be like, when I turn them back off, just be prepared to tell me what else is brought up for you linked to that memory. And so for me, it was hard because I was like, that's all I was thinking about the first session every time she turned it on, and I'm supposed to be thinking about the memory. All I'm thinking about is, what am I supposed to say to her? And what's the right answer? What's the wrong answer? What should I be feeling here? What should I not? Like, I couldn't do it. But once I kind of got used to how it works and stuff, like, it really, really started to help a lot. So, oh, that is you. Yes, her name is Brooklyn. I literally watched your live when I was getting ready to go to the hospital to have her. Oh my gosh, I'm sort of a part of your birth story. How cute is that? Can I show them your daughter? It's okay if not. But she sent me a picture of her daughter where she put the two, like, Mickey Mouse, you know, hair. Oh, look, I happen to have a picture right here. I gotta cover some family members that aren't allowed to be shown. You know that hair I did? It's kind of hard to tell. But I just put it into two, like, loopy buns there. She sent me a picture of her daughter with that hair and said that we did a Shani hairstyle today. It was really cute. That's so cute. You were in the bathtub and I said good luck. That's so cool. That's amazing. Oh my gosh. Let's see. That's good. It's always good to take your meds. Good job. She's almost five. That's so weird. Do you still watch Trisha Paytas? Yeah, I watch like her bump dates, and I'm happy for her. That might be unpopular, but please apologize for her past. We all have a past, and I truly think, like, I've always liked her, even though she's even made a mockery at times of things that I go through. But I don't know. I've always like seen her heart. I think she has a good heart, and I don't know. Anyway, yes. I still find her very harmful to the BPD community, if that makes sense. But hey, yeah, a lot of people feel that way, and that's totally valid. I don't know. I don't watch every single one of her videos. She posts way too often. So I just like pick and choose what I watch. So lately, all I've watched is like her bump dates and stuff. Did she have the baby yet? Yeah, she helped me with my body positivity too. That's the first, like, maybe that's why I have a soft space for her, because the first video I ever saw of her was her like dancing and then talking about how you don't have to look a certain way or be a certain weight to dance and live your best life and do anything you want and da da da. So that was like the very first video I saw of her. And I just kind of fell in love with her personality, even though I know that like 90% of the world cannot stand her personality. I like her. Yeah, Trisha is married, yes. No, she did not rebirth the Queen of England. No. That was funny, though. That's a pretty funny rumor. Oh, man. Okay. Any other questions about where I've been? What's coming up? Trying to remember the Instagram question. I wonder if I could. How is Ed recovery? Well, I was doing really well for a very long time, and this past week I've slipped up twice. So take that how you will. It's not the worst, but it's not the greatest either. So. Yeah. Jen has passed away. Who's Jen? But yeah, it's work in progress, and yeah, it's tough. I don't know who Jen is. Can you tell us anything about the upcoming Day in the Life video you're working on? How can I tell you without giving it away? Well, it's another mental health one. I've done Day in the Life of Bulimic and Day in the Life of Overweight Anorexic. This is another mental health topic, and it's one that's a little bit more broad than eating disorders. So it's not an eating disorder one, I can tell you that. I can tell you that I'm extremely nervous to make it and post it, because it could be a little controversial. Why did that word just leave my head all of a sudden? A little controversial, and I will do my very best to do it in the least triggering way possible. But that's going to be hard to do. But I know that it will benefit more than it might trigger people. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. So I'm trying to think what else I could tell you. I don't know. It's been in my head for a really long time and I just have not dared to do it. And I keep putting it off. I wanted to do it in like the winter time or the summer, maybe. I guess it doesn't matter when I do it. I just am worried that right now, well, maybe, I don't know. I'm gonna do it. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. You're intrigued? Yeah. It's risky. It's really risky. Stay tuned. And I have thought about asking Paul to come and film it like professionally, because Paul is my and Danny's best friend, for those that don't know. He's also in the film industry and he knows he's got equipment, but he's also has access to a lot of equipment in the film industry, people, friends, and he knows how to run cameras and stuff. So I've thought about asking him to film it and making it a little bit better quality, or I could just make it myself and get it up sooner. But I need Danny for it. He has two parts in it that I need him to be here for. So it for sure won't be until at least next month, because he's gone until the 5th of October. So yeah. Thank you. It's hard to put yourself out there like you do. Thank you. Thank you, Stasia. Shan, did you update your phone to iOS 16? I don't know what the freak that is. I have no idea what you're talking about. So probably not. You love my shirt. Thank you. It's a little boy's sweater that I got years ago. It's very thin material, so it's like perfect for end of summer, moving into fall. It's very, very thin and cozy at the same time. Oh no, do we have a situation? It probably got deleted. Did I miss something, Sam? Okay. Thanks, Kimberly. I'm excited to do vlogs again, too. I did vlog today, so you get a vlog soon. I don't usually vlog unless it's Vlogmas or there's like a party or like get together or something. Like, I don't usually film my life unless something is happening, unless it's like a holiday or birthday or something. So I did vlog a little today. I did decide about my, someone just asked that. My tongue. Okay, what about your name change? What are your thoughts on that? I think that I am going to change it back to Educating Shani 2.0. Could even do 3.0 and get really fancy. Should I do 3.0? But yeah, I'm gonna go back to educating Shani. It just, I can do whatever I want on that channel, and it is my name, and I'm so used to it, and I don't like seeing. It's too. I don't like the Shani Banani as the channel name. It's a cute nickname, but I don't think I like it as a channel. So I think I'm gonna change it back. However, I can't do that until I can get this sucker to work. And I can't get this sucker to work because I lost the power cord to it a long time ago. Danny bought me this for Christmas last year, and literally I've never used it. I lost the power cord. I mean, I've used it like a couple times, but I've lost the power cord, and I can only change my name back on a computer. I can't do it from my iPad. I can't do it from my phone. I tried, and it's very frustrating. So I ordered another charger from Amazon. It should get here Friday. So hopefully that'll work, and then I can change my name back. So, yeah. Yeah. Do 4.0 because you don't like the number 3. I'm going to do 3.0. And then I'll probably have another one later in life when I have another turn of events in life, I'm sure. When I have another nervous breakdown or another life-changing thing, then... And I need to take a long break, and then I'll come back and be Shani 4.0. So we'll just keep going up the scale for as long as we need. I don't know. Shani, can I be your friend? Yeah, you can be my online friend. You can comment, and you can send me letters. You can send me messages. It's... What? But just now I get hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people messaging me. So if I don't answer you, if I don't read it sometimes, don't ever take it personally, okay? Hang on, I gotta check something real quick. But I consider you my friend. So hi, friend. Okay, when your schizoaffective disorder active, are you aware the hallucinations are not real? Sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not. I caught another episode on video last night. I don't know if you guys would want me to post that. I thought about possibly doing that if it's happening, because usually what happens is I have this private group chat that I go live on, and I feel very safe with those people, and to the point that like I subconsciously go live if I'm having an episode sometimes, or maybe I'm already live in and I start to have an episode or whatever. And so let me know if you want me to post that, if I ever do catch it on camera, like I did again last night. But for me, it's hard to explain. It feels very real at the time. And I would say 90% of me believes that it's happening and that what I'm hearing is there. And then like, I've got this little tiny 10% that's like logical and being like, there's nothing there. But like the other stuff just overpowers it. So it's like, I have a little pinch of awareness, but I kind of ignore it because the 90% is so overwhelming. And so to answer, I guess I would say, yeah, I would say that it does feel real when it's happening for sure. But later I can go back and I can think about it and know that logically it wasn't real, but while it's happening, Elin, actually, I'm glad you're here. Elin was the one that talked me down out of it last night. I would need her permission to post it, actually, because she's in the video, or I could just cut her out. but she was so super sweet. Not a lot of people were there last night, but she was happened to be there, and she was like, do you want me to come on? So I brought her on, and she like told me that there were no babies and all that, and yeah. So thank you, Elin, for doing that, and let me know if you're okay with me posting you. I could even cut out your face and just post your voice, or I could just not post it at all. I'm totally okay either way. Does it feel similar to Ed Logic? No, not for me. My Ed Logic is more 50-50. I don't know. Maybe in sense that I don't know why. Like, I'm having a hard time describing why. I just don't think it's the same. I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying. Yeah, Elin saved the day last night, so thank you, Elin. What was the question? Did I answer it? I don't know. But yeah, it does, and we talked about that in therapy today, actually. We talked about how, because I told her about the episode I had last night, and the babies and everything, and we talked about what helps me during it, and Elin, I don't know if you have ever witnessed it happen with me, but you somehow knew exactly what to say, so props to you, majorly. Like, thinking back on it, I'm very impressed, because usually what I need is for someone, that's why I went live, to be like, do you guys hear babies crying too, or is it just me? And Elin just knew right what to do, and she was very soft and sweet and said, no honey, there are no babies, and the babies, all of your babies are safe in heaven, and things like that. Sometimes I just need to hear another voice telling me that there are no babies. And then there are times where I go completely nonverbal and I have to walk around the house and find the babies. And you just have to let me do that. So if I'm on a live stream, or if Danny's home or whatever, and an episode happens while I'm also nonverbal at the moment, it becomes like 100% takes over. And I have to go and search every inch of my house for a baby, for a crying baby. So there's different things that help in different situations. It's really fun. Love it. Okay, how long have I been here? It did, Elin. You knew just what to say. I really appreciate it. Because if I had gone on there and I wasn't talking at all, but you knew I was having an episode, and if I say I need to go look, or if I just put the camera down and not come back, it just means I just need to go look and do it. Like with people with like OCD that need to, which I also have struggled with here and there in my life. That have to, like, you know, switch on the light, you know, a few times or whatever, you know what I mean? Like all the OCD tendencies that they've got to do, they've got to get it out of their system. That's kind of how it feels when I'm in a headspace where I need to look at them, look for them, even though there is, you know, obviously part of me knows that there's no baby there, but it's like I have to make sure, I guess, I don't know. Okay. All right. Should I take another couple of questions, or do you guys want me to sing a song? You pick. Either one. If I sing, I know I'll end up being here longer. If I answer questions, I'll probably be going in the next 10 or 20 minutes. So you guys decide. Because once I start singing, I just want to keep singing. Because singing makes me feel happy. But it makes me really, I was explaining before, I have perfect. perfect pitch and I have a perfect musical ear, but I can't execute it perfectly. So I get really frustrated with myself. But that's not the point of why I sing. I sing because it makes me calm. It makes me feel happy. It cheers me up if we do like fun songs and stuff. So yeah. Would I enjoy a doc? I would not enjoy a doc. Docs are beautiful and adorable and loyal and wonderful and so smart. And I wish I could, but all dogs, even the hypoallergenic, all of them have a certain scent that does not go well with my body chemistry. And I always get sick if I'm around a dog, even if it's hypoallergenic, like I get sick to my stomach sick. But they're adorable and I wish I could. I wish I could. But I would rather have a cat. I'm a cat person, but dogs are also amazing and adorable and just so sweet. So I kind of wish I could, but yeah, I can't have a dog or, and then cats, I'm just straight up allergic to, but I desperately want, in the future to get a cat, either a hairless one or a Russian gray. It's the only hypoallergenic one. So yeah, I'm a cat person. I love cats, but dogs are amazing too. My husband is calling. Hi, you're on a YouTube live stream.
Oh, hello, YouTube, from Illinois.
I was right, you're in Illinois.
What?
I was right, you're in Illinois.
You keep breaking up right as you say whatever you're saying.
Because you keep crumpling something on your phone. What is that? Never mind. What? Nothing, never mind. How is it going?
Good. We just landed, so we're here.
How's your hotel looking?
It's fine. Yeah, it's what I expected.
Okay.
So, it's really nothing special. It's kind of like a little homely, I guess is a good word. So, I got a kitchen, which is nice. I requested the kitchen, of course, but that was her prompt. How are you?
So good.
So good, wow.
Yeah.
Good.
Never better.
That's better than I left you.
Yeah.
Which was not so good.
Yeah. Do you want to FaceTime and then they can see you?
Yeah, you want me to FaceTime?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll FaceTime you in a minute. They're all right now. Hello?
Hello? Okay. Why did he hang up? Can't you just do it while you're on the phone? Maybe not. You look tan.
Really? It's the light. Gotta be the light.
Say hi to YouTube.
Hi, guys. Welcome to my house for the next 3 weeks.
That's a big room.
This is my kitchen. Yeah, it's pretty big. There's my bunk beds.
You have a full-size fridge?
Yeah, huh? I got lucky.
Damn. And an oven? Wow. Is this more like an Airbnb or something?
I got bunk. No, it's like a motel. It's just old, so.
Huh.
It's kind of a thing.
Yeah. Maybe it is, yeah. Iz, I miss you. How are you, bro?
The bathroom is in there.
Are you exhausted from driving?
Yeah.
For 2 days straight?
2 days in a freaking truck.
So. Did you have to drive the big truck again?
I did, yeah. We didn't get a very good sleep last night. I didn't want to put Easy through it, so I said, you can drive it home in 3 weeks.
You're very nice to do that.
Yeah.
Danny had to drive, like, the big U-Haul truck, which was very bumpy the entire time.
26-foot. In fact, I even took video of it, like, shaking around. I'll have to send it to you. It's kind of funny, I think.
Yeah.
I haven't watched it, but funny.
Yeah. I miss you.
I miss you. How are you? How are you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah?
Just tubes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you going to bed right now?
All that, I gotta wait like 10 minutes for the guys to show up to come get their bags out of my truck.
Okay.
So, in like 10 minutes, I'll take care of that. That whole house for filming, and you choose the one smallest place, huh?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And what's on the other side of that pony wall that you have your very expensive iPad on?
There's no, I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, just be careful.
It's fine. The nuts are holding it up.
Oh, jeez.
The nuts, no, I wish I could show you guys over top. Can I show you? There you go. See?
All right, that's actually kind of okay.
I know. He's worried it's going to fall. I wish I could play this piano.
Ah, dang it. Where that stupid plug is.
I know. Gotta
where
go somewhere.
It has to have it somewhere.
Yeah.
It's gotta be down one of those stupid boxes in the storage unit, I think. I guess. Or storage room.
Yeah. And I ordered a charger for my laptop because I need it. Couldn't find it anywhere. Because I'm going to change my name back to Educating Shanny.
Why?
I don't know. I just miss it.
Oh. Is that going to confuse people?
No, everyone kind of agrees.
Oh.
We took a vote.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, do you guys have does anyone have a question for Danny while he's here? No, I was going to and then I forgot. This adorable lady, Ken, is that what you go by, Kenny? Sent me a picture of her daughter with the hairstyle I do for Disneyland with the two, you know, and said that they did a Shanny hairstyle on her. How cute is that? And then, like, that little girl knows who I am and everything. How sweet. I'll send you the picture later because I can't show it right now.
Yeah, that's cool.
Let's see if they have any questions for you. Sage, formerly Becca, as you know. Yes. Sage said, will Danny come visit me in Wisconsin? Where the hell is Wisconsin?
It's around here somewhere.
Kennedy.
Probably networking. I'm sorry, Sage. Next time.
You look so tired. Should I let you go?
That's it. Up to you. I'm just going to sit here until they call me to come get their stuff.
You can come watch the live if you want.
I could do that. Maybe I'll do that.
I might sing a song.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll come on there.
Okay. All right. Love you.
Hey, hello.
He's really cute, guys. I'm learning the ukulele, by the way. It's really hard for me. Let me grab it. What was the song I figured out last night? Oh, the pie lullaby, I figured out. Danny, are you here? Are you watching? That's a great question. Yes, Tiffany Gray's Life said, would you bring back the Shanny Penny series? Yes, I definitely want to bring that back. For those that don't know what that is, that's where I have you guys send in your stories and I read them on a video basically, and I respond and get your story, and like it reaches so many people because I'll just put in the title whatever your story is, and then those that are searching for it will find that video, and then you know, I'll be able to like connect you to. So it's a really great way to connect people and who are going through similar things. So yes, I absolutely want to bring it back, and I am. So yeah. Just started. It's really hard for me. I'm not good at like multitasking. So anyway, can the Shammy Femi series be anonymous? Yes, absolutely, absolutely. There's Danny. Danny's on my live stream. That's so romantic. Danny, I can do the pie lullaby out of the chords. Look. Danny encouraged me every day to practice the ukulele. So I just started, so I'm not very good at it, but it's really fun. You can sing too? That's awesome. Singing is wonderful. Okay, do we want one more question or do we want to sing? You guys decide. Everyone said sing before, but. Because every time I sing, I'm always like, okay, one more. Okay, one more. So I know I'll be here longer if I sing, but yeah, I'm good either way. Yeah, I'm just learning. I'm not very good. I'm not very coordinated, so it's hard for me to like get the right strum and like keep on beat is really, really hard for me to do. So I'm working on it. Sing. Okay, what do you want me to sing? Over the rainbow. Somewhere over the rainbow, I started to hide. Sing Creep. In honor of Morgan, maybe? Shallow. You like the shallows? We start with a fun one that will warm me up really well. It's one of my favorites to sing. I hope my battery doesn't die. I think it might. Maybe I should go and get the charger. Yeah, let me go grab my charger. I'll be right back. Thank you. That's not the right charger. I'm really smart. I need some Yoo-hoo first. Delicious. Okay. We're gonna start with, this is my favorite, the theme. Tell me if the music is too loud or vice versa, if it's not loud enough. This is from Waitress the Musical, one of my favorites. Ugh. Oh, I can't even hear it.
I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimize the guessing game. Guess what?
What?
I don't like guessing games or when I feel things before I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he could ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name or he knows, but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most, what scares me the most is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can't hide from it? What happens then if when he knows me, he's only disappointed? What if I give myself away, only getting the other half? I could never count. So I'm just fine inside my shell-shaped mind. This way I get the best view, so that when he sees me, I want to.
Dawn, don't you think you're being a little, maybe just a 10?
I'm not defensive. I'm simply being cautious. I can't repress the suiting due to my miscalculating lie. A certain suitor stands in line, I've seen in movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable wife. Sorry, girls. But he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. He could be untrustworthy as that, he could be less than kind. Or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What would I do with that? What if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? Someone who when he sees
hard to sing sometimes, but it's fun. Oh, okay. All right. Any requests now that I'm warmed up a little bit? I will tell you, I don't think I have much in me. That was very hard for me. But maybe sometimes singing a second time warms me up more and then I feel better. You're getting tired? Go to sleep then. Oh, we should do like, what's the one, the Lion King one that I did. We should do that. That's a really fun one.
With the Smiths rewards card, earn fuel points to save big at the pump. For the win!
I did know that, Tiff. I did. Maybe I should go get some honey. Okay, any requests? Otherwise, I'm gonna go. No, I don't dance. I don't dance. Don't ask that of me. I do not do it. I have no coordination. Did anyone else request? Let me look back and see if it would help if I actually looked at my comments. Can you feel the love tonight? Creep. At least try Can You Feel the Love. Is there... I wonder if Clark's done that. Clark. He did do it. Wait. It's from the musical? Is that the same thing? I guess we'll find out. I love Little Mo.
I can see what's happening.
What?
And they don't have a clue.
Who?
They'll fall in love, and here's the bottom line. Our trio's down to two.
Oh.
The sweet caress of twilight. There's magic everywhere. And with all this romantic atmosphere, disaster's in the air.
Can I sing first? Oh, okay, hold on, hold on. Where do I sing? I love Clark, but Clark, that version is not it. Probably because it's not the actual thing. Hold on a minute. I don't know if I can find like a duet though. No one else did it yet. Okay, what else? What else? You're cute. Thanks, Natasha. Or Love Will Find a Way. What is that? Do I know that? What else? It's the movie version. Yeah. Okay, you can stay up to hear me sing. Love that. Ariel, you want me to do Little Mermaid? She used to be mine. I can attempt it. Last time I tried to do this, I started getting emotional, so. But I'll try it. It's not simple to say that most days I don't recognize me with these shoes and this apron. That place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true. There is never attention, sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. I need something. I'll be right back. Hold on. Makes you believe it's all true. Now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and be right and then be with you. For the girl that she's bruised and gets used by you.
what she used to be. You are welcome for that performance. Well, seriously, one of the greatest musicals of all time is Waitress. So good. Oh my gosh, that's so sweet, Brittany. Thank you. Aww. Perfection, no, but fun. It's fun to sing. I had a breakup and this is cheering me up. I'm sorry I had a breakup. Who is it? Give me their name. Who would break up with you? Or did you break up with them? Music classes. You see me doing music classes with littles. My mom actually used to do that. I'm glad you joined too. Does anyone want me to sing anything else or should I go? What else? I'm not singing Creep. Not unless Danny's here. That's our song, kind of. It was from Waitress, the musical. So freaking good. So good. It's about a girl, a woman that gets pregnant by her abusive husband and her... I don't want to give anything away, but you'll sob if you watch it. It's... Danny, I can't do Creep unless you're here. The mermaid song, like the Little Mermaid. Danny, stop. I can't do it if you're not here. Do I know it on the uke yet? No. Yeah, but like, it's not good. I don't like singing with the karaoke track to Creep. It's so good. I wish I could tell you how it ends, but I don't want to spoil it. Good to see you too, Jenny. How are you? When will my life begin? Have I ever done that one? Let's try. When will my life begin? Karaoke. Here we go. Let's give it a shot. To this? I should. It's my favorite Disney movie. Seven, eight. 7 a.m. the usual morning in my room. 7 the choices we killed, boys are clean. Polish and wax, be laundry and mop and shine up. Sleep again, and by then it's like 7:15. So I'll read a book, or maybe 2 or 3. I've had a few paintings to my gallery. Play guitar and think and basically just sing it. When will my life begin? This is hard to sing. This is a lot. Then after lunch, it's puzzles and cards and baking. Picking the shape in ballet and chess. Pottery and intricate candle making. Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch. Take it time, so it dries. And then I'll reread the books if I have time to spare. And I'll drink all summer. I'm sure there's still somewhere. And then I brush it. Stuck in the same place and always been. keep wondering and wondering, wondering, wondering if only life begins. Tomorrow night, the lights will appear, just like they do on my birthday each year. What is it like out there where they glow? Now that I'm older, Mother might just let me go.
Okay, that was hard. Don't ask me to do that one again, because that was really hard. That was way too fast. My heart will go on. That's when I can actually play on the piano. Too bad my piano's not working.
Every night in my dreams, I see you. You feel you.
There you go. Love Tanglewood. You guys are too sweet. Jeez. For what one did you want? My heart will go on. Do you want me to sing that? Our wedding song was Valentine by Martina McBride. I don't know if I can sing that. Danny, are you still here? If Danny's still here, I'll sing it. I don't think it fits my voice very well, but I could try. Oh, really? Oh, I will sing it for you then, Kennedy. Danny's here. Okay, I will sing. My heart will go on. Just know that I'm going to be dramatic about it, because I can't sing it I can't sing it seriously. So I hope that doesn't offend you. It's just one of the ones I can't do it seriously. I don't know why. It's literally it's from my favorite movie and everything. My heart will go on karaoke. Never enough. Great idea. Danny is here. I could attempt it.
Only $6. Only $6. Only $6. Only six.
Ah, it's measured like a good.
Danny has yet to hear me sing Never Enough fully without making fun and making it crappy. I'm not like singing this song. It makes me uncomfortable, and I don't know why.
Harden, my heart will go on and on. Love can touch us one time and last for a lifetime. And I'll never let go until we're gone.
My voice is done, guys. It's like very wiggly and creepy right now.
In my life, we'll always go on. If I were
not good for me to sing. It doesn't fit my voice at all. But it was fun.
Well, guys, y'all, is everyone doing okay?
Don't waste your voice on a song you're uncomfortable singing. True. Good point. I wonder if there's a song I'm comfortable singing. Let me see if I can do it. And if not, then we're done. How about that? Let's do Summer Nights, because it always makes me happy. Even though I've done it a bajillion times, get over it. It's the greatest, it makes me happy.
Je suis d'accord, tu me rappelles. Si je suis pas là, je suis chez les filles.
I'm good today. Well, we'll see if I'm good today. This one's easier for me to sing a little bit. I'm gonna end on this and then I'm gonna go. So.
Summer loving had me a blast.
Summer loving happened so fast.
I met a girl crazy for me.
Met a boy cute as can be.
Summer days, you're a dinner place.
I'm okay, Tim. I'm okay. I just couldn't do that last song. That takes way more like talent and work and ability to do, so this one's easier.
Please remind me, got me sinking.
I saved her life, she nearly drowned.
She showed up, splashing around. Summer sun, something's begun.
Okay, on that note, I'm gonna go. Thanks for hanging out, you guys. I love you. Are you dressing up for Halloween? You should come live dressed up. Maybe I will. And of course I'm dressing up. I always dress up. Halloween's very big in my family. So I already have my costume and I'm really excited about it, but I'm not gonna tell you what it is, sorry. So you're welcome. Okay, I love you guys and I'll see you soon for, you'll see, next thing you'll see is like a vlog, which is fun. So that's coming. Thanks for letting me do this instead of the Q&A. I'll do a Q&A another time, I guess. And my skin is, oh, I shouldn't pull it off because it's just gonna make it worse. Oh, I need to stop picking at it. Okay, I love you guys. I'll see you really soon. Remember forever and always that you're beautiful, you're worth it, and I am too. Have a good night. Love you, goodbye.